Hello everyone, I'm Jean, the DCM practitioner and instructor in Victoria, BC, Canada. Here is my online class for ENT and eye problems for DCM practitioner and acupuncturist. The book we use I put below here. I can help the students to study and review for the class. Let's start. The first one we're talking about acute conjunctivitis. Conjunctivitis is inflammation happens in the conjunctiva area. So that's usually caused by bacterial infections. So mainly problems. If we see the patient, we can find the red eyes in there. And the patient feels some painful in there. And maybe some discharging coming. So that is a contaminated kind of illness. It usually happens in one side of the eye, but it's pretty soon go to other side of the eye. And very often happens like in the spring or maybe early summer season, yeah, warm kind of weather. It's an epidemic kind of illness. So we still say orifice problems. Mainly is external passenger and maybe combined with internal reason together. So this illness mainly is wind heat attacking. Yeah. Mainly is wind heat attacking. That's head air still belong to upper jaw. So that's the mainly reason. But possible people have some underlying body condition, maybe some internal heat, that's a combination together and then cause these problems. Clinical symptoms. Yeah, clinical symptoms. We say like other eye problems, we have some commonly symptoms under sight. Itchy eyes. It's not truly painful, but mainly itching. Or maybe people feel some uncomfortable feeling of the eyes. That's possible. Yeah, uncomfortable. Or maybe itchiness, and feel something inside the eye, but nothing in there. So severe kind of case, patient photophobia. So photophobia, just eye symptoms, can cause by internal reason, can cause by external reason. Aversion to light, yeah, photophobia, aversion to light. And even some burning sensation and a high release sensation in the eyelid. So that's possible. And other symptoms. We talk about conjunctiva area, some edema swollen in there. Yeah, edema swollen in there. And even some discharging, yeah, past kind of discharging. And some severe case, maybe some bleeding. Yeah, maybe some bleeding. So that's the second symptom there. So let's go back our picture before. Yeah, this picture. So conjunctiva, they cover inside our eyelid. and also cover superficial of the sclera area of the eye. So basically, that's they cover. That's it. They cover. They are not truly cover cornea area. Yeah, they are not truly cover cornea area. So if we look here, if we look here from front side, so basically Rani's scalar area, so that's Rani's in this area. They're not invading the like a pupil area, not blocking the vision. So these problems basically no vision problems. Yeah, vision is still normal. Yeah, vision is still normal. But they just happens in the superficial of the eyes. They can see some redness in there, and the patient feel itchiness in there, and this uncomfortable feeling in there. So that's pretty superficial. And we talking about before, it usually happens when eyes first, and then transfer to another. We say that's a contaminated kind of illness. When people washing their face, it's pretty easily go to other eyes. Or maybe sometimes it's directly go to both sides eyes problems. This illness, usually, it's getting worse 3 to 4 days, and then relieve about 1 week to 2 weeks. So even in the radio, we didn't see like we must use some medication to treat it. It can be cured by itself. Certainly some like eye drips can help, yeah, can help to relieve, but not necessary to use some special medication to oral take or even injections. So it's not that severe kind of problem, but truly scared people, like when people have red eyes and also very uncomfortable feeling happens in the eyes. But not that severe. Then we're talking about the TAC and RTCM treatment. So we say these illness can cure it by itself, but with treatment, we can shorter the time for people recover more early, more early. So that's why we're talking about the treatment. So V heat type is more popular. And V heat type is more popular. So locally, still same symptoms there. Itchiness, uncomfortable feeling, feel something inside the eyes, and photophobia, and maybe some tears, discharging tears. So that's local symptoms. Yeah, that's local symptoms. And also for eyelid, possible eyelid slightly swollen in there, discharging in there. So mainly is local symptoms here. Then when we talking about wind heat type, we talking about wind heat attacking, our vision to wind slightly fewer. That's EPI type. Yeah, that's EPI type. And the possible patient have a headache, and the possible we talking about wind heat is most deepness of nose compared with wind cold is more runny nose. The pulse floating, yeah, and rapid. peak time here, you can think about the normal time here. First 2 days, usually not changing the time, color, and white coating is still normal. So that's local symptoms plus pattern symptoms. That's our wind heat type. And our treatment principle, dispersing wind, clear, heat, and you can add in like a benefit eyes there. The points, we're still thinking about local points, like Sandel 23, Acro points, VR, Still remember, VR in the center of the eyeball, and the Taiyang, Samuel 2. The question here, do we use usually local points? We use stomach 1. We use bladder 1. Do we use stomach 1, bladder 1 for this case? Yeah, why not? Why not? It's good points for the eyes. Why not? Yes, you are right. Yeah, pay attention. Usually we're talking about local points around the eyes. That should be, bladder too should be okay because they are on the eyeball. It's not beside the eyes. Yeah. Certainly when we do needling, still be careful or fingers not touching the eyeball. And pretty clear our fingers, this factor in there for our finger. Now too close to eyes. Stomach 1 and bladder 1 is too close to eyes. But bladder 2 is okay. VR is okay on the eyeball. VR is okay. Bladder 2 is okay. So we are now to use stomach 1, bladder 1 for this case, because too close to the eyeball, that's a contaminate of the illness, that's the risk for infections. And the other points, we still have some distal points here. Remember, any kind of eye problems, we can use this point is gallbladder 37. That's for TTM name. We're talking about Guangming. Guang is light. Guang is light. Ming is bright, still light. So that means these points specially working for the eyes, treat eyes problems. So that's these toys, any kind of eye problems, we can go to these toys, use for distal toys. So some Chinese toys name, there are something relationship with the functions. If you can try to remember some more Chinese pin name, maybe help you to remember the function. Certainly it's harder to remember all of the names, but for some special kind of points, try to remember some key names. And the LA4 common points for the height, certainly including for the eyes. Then we're talking about the pattern points here. So pattern points here, we are in the wind heat type. Blue 14, clear heat. Goblet 20 is good points, both for external wind and even for internal wind. And the lung 7. So that's low connecting points of the lung is good for relief pattern there. So that's for all treatment. The second pattern, we're talking about the overall activity of the lung heat. So that means like some heat go to deeper, go to the lung. That's still start from EPI wind heat, but they evading to the lung. So local symptoms pretty similar, photophobia. Still remember that word, aversion to light. And some tears, yeah, inflammation, some tears. And some burning pain. Yeah. Compare with wind heat type. Wind heat type, we say mainly itchiness. And mainly feel some uncomfortable feeling there. But right now we got some painful in here. Even not that severe. Yeah. Burning kind of pain is not that severe kind of pain, but it is some pain in there. And some discharging. Yeah, and some discharging. So still some eyelid part, still some edema there. And on the conjunctivitis air, conjunctiva air, some edema there. And red color, yeah, red color. So all the symptoms here is local symptoms, yeah, local symptoms. Basically, pretty similar, yeah, this is a little bit painful, yeah, compared with each knee. And pattern symptoms. When we're talking about lung heat, we must have some symptoms relationship with lung. Cough. Yeah. Cough. So basically, when we're talking about lung problems, symptoms relationship, maybe cough, maybe short breath, maybe asthma, and the chest congestions. So here, is cough. Yeah. And some internal heat symptoms. Thirsty. Yeah. Thirsty. Internal heat symptoms. And the dry sound here is coming from internal heat. Simply sometimes could be coming from external heat. But the dry stool is internal heat. So the pulse rapid, that heat pulse, but it's not floating anymore. We didn't talk about the floating pulse in here. And the right tongue with yellow coating, that's internal heat. So that's internal heat in the lung. So our treatment principle, clear heat and the purging passenger fare, basically. With a severe heat and a heat rising up, we call it a fear. But generally, it's a clear heat. And the benefit eyes. So our points here, still local points. Yeah, still local points. Still not too close to eyes. Yeah, still not too close to eyes for local points. And we still have some distal points. Bladder three. Little bit distal. Bladder channel truly go to the eyes so that we can go to some distal points. And the other points, we say that's pattern points. Clear heat from the lung. Clear heat. So lung five, certainly water points in the lung. Clear heat in the lung, clear heat in the lung. And the 214, we can use for both external heat and internal heat. Yeah, we can clear heat from there. And LI11, that's generally clear internal heat points. Especially people have heat in the lung. That has the lung, that's a zhangfu relationship in there. So that's a pretty good point to clear heat. So that's the heat in the lung pattern. Then we talk about another pattern here, fear in the liver and the lung. So when we talk about fear, that means more severe heat. Yeah, more severe heat. Compare when we only talk about heat. So basically local symptoms is pretty similar. We still have photophobia, we still have some burning kind of eye pain in there, and the rhinitis in there, swollen in there, edema in the eyelid there. And also we say this illness usually is not invading the corneal area. But this severe kind of heat, we're talking about fear in the liver and the lung, they truly can go to superficial part of the cornea. So that's some spots in there. Great white color, cloudy in there. That's we name it. Nobia before. So that's we go by. Nubra. So that's invading the cornea area, some cloudy kind of a cover in the cornea area that we call nubra. So that means some nubra in there. And other symptoms, yeah. So that's the local symptoms, yeah. Above here. And below here is the pattern symptoms. So pattern symptoms, hypochondrial pain. So liver fear, mainly coming from liver tissue stagnation. Liver tissue stagnation changing to heat. So that's the hypochondriac air, that's the liver air. And the bitter taste in the mouth. That means heat, especially in the liver and the gallbladder. Dry south, that's some internal heat, damage body fluid. So people feel dryness. Rapid pulse, heat pulse, very pulse go to liver. And the right part on the side part, so that we say side part is the liver and the gallbladder part. So some dryness in there because heat, especially in the liver. And the yellow tongue coating, is heat. So look like for the picture here, we didn't see specially go to the lung. So this pattern mainly is liver heat. Yeah, mainly is liver heat. So treatment principle, purging the fear from the liver, and they say promotion and dispersing function of the lung are not necessary in there. We didn't see too much symptoms relationship with the lung. So I believe they're still thinking about eye problems, orifice, internal reason and external reason relationship in there. And the external reason originally coming from EPI. That's relationship with the lung in there. But the mainly pattern for this illness is the liver fat in here. And the clear heat benefit the eyes. So the poise, we still say local poise, yeah, not too local, yeah, local poise, not too local. For acute conjunctivitis, yeah, local poise, not too local. And we still can use the same distal poise And then we're talking about the pattern points. So pattern points, we mainly clear heat from the liver gallbladder. Yeah, from the liver gallbladder. Basically, we still not necessarily go to lung 5, but we still can keep LI-11. Yeah. LI-11 basically clear internal heat. Yeah, clear internal heat.